Welcome to week 29 of your 40-week pregnancy journey. Feel free to let out a sigh of relief. If your baby comes early, he or she now has a greater than 90% chance of living a long and healthy life with the help of quality NICU care. Your baby's development at week 29. At 29 weeks, the baby is size of an acorn squash. Your 29-week baby already measures about 15.2 inches long. They weigh about 2.5 pounds, but still they have a way to go. Can you believe that baby will be triple in weight before birth? Your little one is getting ready to meet you. She's starting to gain weight more quickly. During the last 2.5 months of pregnancy, she'll continue to put on more padding and will likely double her current weight. Although the major body and the organ development work is nearly complete, her lungs may not be enough mature for the life outside the womb just yet. You might notice your baby is kicking more often, and those kicks are getting stronger as your baby changes her position from time to time. When you are 29 weeks pregnant, your healthcare provider may advise you to count her fetal movements once each day. Baby's muscles, lungs, and his or her head, which needs to expand to accommodate baby's swiftly developing brain, is also getting bigger. Baby is starting to regulate his or her own body temperature. As more fat is deposited under the skin surface, his wrinkled skin is smoothing out. This white fat, as it is called, is different from the earlier brown fat your developing fetus accumulated. Brown fat is necessary for body temperature regulation, while white fat actually serves as an energy source. Your little one is continuing to hiccup. They feel like light, rhythmic taps to you and are not uncomfortable for baby either. The sonograph this week shows that your baby's heart beats around 110 to 150 beats per minute. Your common symptoms this week. Some of the symptoms which you may experience during this week might include: number 1, hemorrhoids. Hemorrhoids are very common at this stage of pregnancy, and the reasons are twofold. Firstly, your amped up blood flow and growing uterus causes a lot of pressure inside your abdomen, prompting veins in your rectum to swell. Secondly, the progesterone uptake you're experiencing causes food to move through your intestines more slowly, which can result in constipation. Number 2, constipation. As with many other pregnancy symptoms, pregnancy hormones are the culprit behind constipation. Progesterone causes the muscles in your bowels to relax, allowing the food to hang around longer in the digestive tract. Number 3, heartburns. Early in pregnancy, your body produces large amounts of hormones, progesterone and relaxin, which tend to relax smooth muscle tissues throughout your body, including those in your gastrointestinal tract. Heartburns occur when the ring of the muscle that separates the esophagus from the stomach relaxes, allowing the food and harsh digestive juices to back up from the stomach to the esophagus. So here are some self-care tips during this week. Some of the self-care tips which you should follow during this week might include: number 1, preventing hemorrhoids. Hemorrhoids are a common problem at week 27 and beyond. Here are some ways to help ease your discomfort. Take a sitz bath where you gently run warm water over your hemorrhoids while situated on a mini tub that fits directly over your toilet. Avoid standing for long stretches. Consume plenty of fiber such as whole wheat, flax, fruits with skins, vegetables, brown rice and lentils. Drink plenty of water to keep your digestive tract moving. Exercise regularly to help moving waste through your intestines. Don't strain while on the toilet. Constipation related straining can actually cause hemorrhoids. Number 2, preventing constipation. You don't have to resign yourself to 9 months of discomfort. There are plenty of tactics to combat constipation. That is, fight back with fiber. Fiber rich foods help you eliminate waste. Aim for 25 to 35 grams of fiber each day. Resist refined. Try to avoid refined grains which include white bread, white rice, refined cereals and pasta. Drink about 8 to 10 glasses of fluids a day. Don't max out at your meal time. Go when you got to go. Consider your supplements and medication. Do your Kegel muscle exercises. Stay away from stimulant laxatives. Number 3, preventing heartburns. There are several ways to control and treat heartburn during pregnancy, and with so many options and so much time, you'll probably try them all, such as: chew on sugarless gums, add almonds to your diet, because eating a few almonds after each meal, since they are very tasty, and neutralize the juices in the stomach, which may relieve and prevent heartburn. Get milk, eat fresh, dried or freeze-dried papaya, as it helps to relieve heartburn for some women and scores vitamin A and vitamin C too. So in the nutshell, here is your week 29 checklist. Continue taking prenatal vitamins. Continue drinking about 8 to 12 glasses of water a day. Continue doing your Kegel exercises daily. Review your calcium intake and make changes if needed. Discuss your partner's role in labor and birth. Thank you. Please like, subscribe and share our YouTube channel, The Voice of Women, and press the bell icon to stay tuned for the latest updates.